Hey everyone, Matt here with the Maya Learning Channel. Today I want to quickly talk about the importance of scene scale when it comes to simulating in Bifrost. So when working in 3D, you have the choice of working at different sizes at various points in the pipeline. For example, you may model your assets at full size or even larger than full size just to make detailing them easier. But afterward, you may decide to scale everything down in order to save memory or improve performance. However, when it comes to effects like smoke, water, and fire, having a realistic scale is important because they're modeled on real-life phenomena. The math involved depends on accurate forces feeding them in order to generate a physically correct result. That's why Bifrost allows you to change the scale of an effect independently from the other objects in your scene. This way, even if your scene has been sized differently from the real world, you can still produce a result that represents the size you want to portray. Let's take a look at an example. So here we have a smoke trail effect that I generated in a previous tutorial. Before comparing any scale differences, I first need to go to the source air node and switch the resolution mode. Relative is fine for behavior testing because it scales emitter voxels to give consistent performance at any size. But when testing for quality, absolute ensures that we get the most accurate look in world space units. Now that that's out of the way, let's check out the current scene scale, down here in the Aero Solver Settings node. In this case, a value of 1 means that, as far as my smoke is concerned, 1 grid space is equal to 1 meter. That means it's going to act as though my trilobot here is about 2 to 3 meters wide and 3 to 4 meters long. Now, this may or may not be what I intended. Remember, simulation scale is handled independent of actual model scale. Suppose I'd only built the model at half scale. Let's see what happens if I scale it up. The difference is immediately noticeable. Look at all this detail I'm suddenly getting. Unfortunately, this puts me in a bit of a bind. I like this trail better, but I really shouldn't be changing the size of my asset, especially if I'm planning to reference it into other scenes that are sized accordingly. The last thing I want to do is to scale everything associated with this one asset. Luckily, I won't have to. Instead, let's change the Aero Solver Settings scene units to 2. This essentially doubles the size of my simulation space for the purposes of the smoke, which in theory should give me the exact same result as a smoke when I doubled the size of the entire asset. Except it doesn't. The smoke looks very thin compared to my previous scale. Think about it. If I pump the same amount of smoke into a space that's twice as big, that smoke is going to spread out a lot more and thus look a lot thinner. So to offset that, I'm going to increase the density of the smoke. In this case, that density value is actually coming from this vary node, which randomizes the thickness over time. So I'll just double the maximum value possible. By the same logic, I'll need to double my influences as well, which I can do by increasing the max modulation value that feeds them. Then the dissipation I'll handle separately. I can leave inherent velocity alone, since speed and direction are independent of size. And now if I play my scene, I get something much closer to what I was going for. This same logic applies at any scale, but we generally recommend deciding on your simulation scale first before creating your effect. That makes for the easiest workflow.